Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we will be looking on how to do a structured meshing for an aircraft wing. I have imported the geometry to ICM CFD and have already done the boolean operator to subtract the aircraft domain from the outer domain. You can do this using any kind of CAD software or design modeler itself. So before moving on to meshing, I will just show you our parts. This is our inlet, this is our outlet, this is a symmetrical part, and the inside one is the aircraft wing. So let's directly jump to our meshing process. To start with, let's create a block around the semispherical domain over here. We'll name this as fluid and apply. So we'll make some of the split so as to capture the geometry properly. So I'm using biscuit point method over here. This is the edge and this is my point. So our next process is association. So we'll associate corresponding edges to corresponding curves. For that, we'll go to associate menu, edge to curve association. So these two edges to this. One second. This three edges to this two. And this three edges to these two curves. And again, this three edges to the center curves. Let me select it again. Yes, now let's project the vertices. Now we can actually use a spline tool to capture the geometry more precisely. For that, let's go to edit edges, go to spline tool, and let's create enough amount of splits. Spline tool, we're going with spline method, and let's do create enough amount of splits to capture the geometry. Sorry. Yeah, we can actually do for these edges too. And the next thing is we can actually copy the parameters. I'll just show you in a second. We can actually link edges that are the source edge will be this and our target edge will be this. So like that, we can do for other edges too. So linking will help to capture the geometry even more precisely. So I guess we are done with our initial first stage. Even we can linkage between, we can keep this thing as source edge and we can link this edge. Same for this too. Yes, so now we are done with our first part. Even this edge also can be done. So let me do that too. So now the block is able to capture the geometry properly. Our next process is to create an O-grid inside our current block. For that, let's go to blocking, split edge, create O-grid, and we'll select these two blocks at first, and we have to select two of the front faces too, this and this. Now let's apply. So now a pretty good block has been created. If we need, we can actually move the vertex to align all the things more precisely, like moving this to align towards this line. I'll just show you once. We'll just lock the moment only with respect to x and y axis. We'll just lock with respect to z axis, and we can just move it like this. So this can actually more precisely capture the geometry. So I guess that will be enough now. So now let's go to index control. Let's go to index control and I'll just switch off the outer part of the O-grid. Now our main concern is this. Now we will create enough amount of split so as to create a small block around our aircraft wing. For that, let's go to blocking, split. We should split along x, y and z axis. So let me start with this. 1, 2. Now I'll just change our view to perpendicular to y axis. Now one split should be here and another one should be here. Okay, so now we have created a block. So now we can actually move the vertex so that it looks more capable of accommodating the curves. So let's move with respect to we can actually lock y axis, and we can move with respect to x axis only. So we'll just lock y and z, and we'll move with respect to x. Yes, so that will be enough. So let me just go to index control and again select the corner that we need. Now we have to create enough amount of splits so as to capture the turns in the aircraft wing. For that, we'll go to blocking again, split edge, and I'll just use prescribe point method again. So initially I'll just use this as my edge and this as my point, this edge, this point. Similarly, you have to do the process for all the turns. That will be enough. Again, go to index control and we select this and this edge. Yes. So our next process is to associate vertex to points. So let's start from this side. We'll go for blocking, associate vertex to point, this vertex to this point, this vertex to this point. Similarly, this to this, this to this. This to this and this to this. Now we have associated all points towards the leading edge. Now we have to let me just zoom towards the trailing edge. So our trailing edge is actually a blunt trailing edge, and we are having two points over here. So we will just associate the upper vertex to upper point and lower vertex to lower point. Again, same procedure. Let's repeat for all other points towards the trailing edge now. Excuse me. I guess we are having 4 more points. No, 6 more we have. Please make sure that you are properly associating corresponding vertex to corresponding points. So if you are messing up with any of association, you can always deassociate using this menu, vertex, edge or faces, anything. One more point remaining. So now we have completed all our point to vertex association. Our next step is to associate the edges to curves that are these edges to curves. So we'll start with that now. So initially we'll start from this side. So I'll associate this edge to this curve, this edge to this curve. And if you come to the leading edge, this edge should be associated with these two curves. And this to this, actually here is a curve and a line. I'll just switch off the edges so you can see the curve. I'll just switch off the curve. See, these are the curves. Okay, so I have to associate this edge to this curve. Similarly, you have to follow the procedure for all the parts, I mean edges. Check if all edges are associated or not, you can just switch off the curves. so that if the color is changed to green, it means that it's associated. So if you zoom towards the trailing edge, you can actually see that we are having two more edges at each of the sections. So we had associated with respect to corresponding curves. So we can do that now. So this is one of the most time consuming part in this meshing process. So just be careful with the association. Please make sure that you are associating correct edges to correct curves. So I guess I'm done with all kinds of association in this aircraft wing. So let me just switch off the curve and see the color of our blocking. Since everything is associated, now let's try pre-meshing it now. So I'll go to blocking, I'll reset everything and we will just switch off the internal edges now. And I'll just change to solid frame. Before moving on, we just forgot to actually name our solid wing as a solid body. So for that, we can go to parts, we can create a part, and we can name the part as solid wing, and we can actually select the block. So our block will be, so let me just reset everything. Okay. So our blocks will be these five blocks that we created. You can actually create this before even splitting into different parts. Since we forgot, I'm doing it right now. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so these five will be our block, and let's apply it. So it has already been applied. Now let's try pre-meshing it, and I will again go to index control, and yes. So this is how our airfoil looks right now. Since the number of elements are very less, it looks so rigid. So now let me go to mesh parameters and increase the factor to 2 till we get a good number of elements. I guess 8000 will be fine. I will just revert it to 0.9 again. Yes, 8640 elements we have. So this will be fine for now. Now we can actually give a number of elements to each of the edges. So let me start from this. So I'll give it 15, we'll give almost 25 for this. 25. This will be 15. This will be 10. This again 15, and this will be 15 again. and the cross elements will be almost 25 we can give, I guess, and we can copy the parameters to parallel just to and apply. Now let's pre-mesh it again. So now we can see that the airfoil geometry or the aircraft wing geometry is captured properly. Now the next thing we have to do is that we can actually increase the number of elements towards our trailing edge. For that, let me select one of the edges. So this arrow marks actually the point where the arrow marks show, or the direction of arrow mark is the second point and other one is the first point. So if you need to increase the element towards the second point, you can actually change the ratio. Ratio is nothing but the growth rate. I have changed the growth rate to 0.1.1, and the initial spacing should be the initial size of the element should be 0.003, and I'll just pre-mesh it again. So now you can see that there are a lot of number of elements towards the trailing edge. So this helps to capture the flow more precisely now. So we can repeat the procedure similarly for this edge too. So I'll again select this edge, and I'll give number of elements as 15 will be enough, and growth rate as 1.1 here, and this will be similar, the spacing also should be 0.03. okay, so let me try to pre-mesh it again. So now you can see the number of elements towards the this edge also is increased. So that will be fine for now. So our next process will be to create an O grid around the solid wing, and we will try to improve the surface and volume mesh. So this is the end of first part of the video, and we will see in second part. Thank you for watching.